American War is a story of a fictional second American Civil War. It takes place about 50 years from now. And it's the story of a single family, the Chestnuts, and what the war does to them. It's really a book about radicalization. It's a book about revenge. I don't think of it as a book about America particularly. It just happens to be set in America. I've been thinking about it for a long time, for many years, but I started writing in the summer of 2014, and I finished the first draft in the summer of 2015. So I was writing for almost exactly a year. About 3 weeks after I finished the first draft, Donald Trump announced he was running for president, and the book came out 4 months into the Trump administration. And so this book that I never really intended to be about America literally has been taken that way, has been taken as a book about America because of the situation in that country right now. But even though this is a book set in the future and set in America, it's not concerned with an American future. It's concerned with somebody else's past and somebody else's present. So the title American War comes from a line in the book where one of the characters says, "Everyone fights an American war." So one of the things I was trying to do with the novel is take elements of conflict that have happened on the other side of the planet, sometimes at the hands of America, you know, drone killings, waterboarding, the real effects of war. And instead of having them happen on the other side of the planet, I wanted to make them happen in the heart of America. So the point was to get people to look at something that it was very easy to look away from. That was the central point of making it an American war, is to get people not to ignore things that they otherwise might find easy to ignore. Yeah, so a lot of things that happen in America, because America is such a loud place, there's a tendency to think that these things are unique to America. But they're not. One of the things I saw when I would go through the South in America is I saw people who would behave very similarly to the people I grew up with in the Middle East. There was a kind of stubbornness, there was a kind of holding on to tradition at all costs. You know, if you live in America, you tend to think of that as an American phenomenon. Oh, this is what the South is like. But it was very, very similar to the folks I grew up with in the Middle East. It's, you know, the language is different and the culture is different and so on, but there's something at the root of it that's very similar. And American War is a book that's in many ways about the similarities we have as human beings. I've been a migrant since the age of 5. I was born in Egypt, but I left Egypt when I was 5 years old, and I lived in Qatar in the Middle East. Qatar is one of those places that didn't really have many cultural industries, movies, music, books. So everything was imported. And so from a very young age, I was reading American books, I was watching American movies. That was the culture that I sort of adopted. And so when I came to Canada, when I came to North America, I felt that maybe I understood this part of the world because I had grown up reading those books and watching those movies. And I didn't at all. I didn't understand a single thing about America. I understood about the mythology of America, not the reality. And so American War was written in the first few years after I had moved to the United States. So I was in this place where the mythology of America, the things I had believed about America, were fading away and the reality of America was becoming clear. And so American War was written during that time period when I was trying to come to terms with the big difference between what I thought America was and what America really is. The book I always recommend these days is the best book I read last year, which is a book called This Accident of Being Lost. And it's by a writer named Leanne Beresamosaki Simpson, who's an indigenous writer. She lives in Canada. And the book is a collection of short stories, poems, and songs. And they have very little in common. And actually, as I tell you this, I realize it's going to be very difficult for me to explain why I love this book so much, because there's nothing in common with the things in it. Except that it's about love, and it's about belonging, and it's about identity, who you are. And it's just one of those books that my friend gave it to me. I'd never heard of the writer, I'd never heard of the book, and it just resonated in a way that that I would have never expected. It's beautifully written, it's very underappreciated. I don't know how well it sold outside Canada, but I suspect not very well at all. And it deserves far more attention than it's gotten.